your school. The Adams Innovation. Once upon a time, in a village called Goop, there lived a family of mathematicians. The town was called Goop because it was filled with blue goop. The goop fell from the sky like rain. Sometimes it could get up to 4 feet of goop. The Adams family was very poor and only had $1,000, hardly even enough money to buy a bed. The whole family lived in a colorless house with old paint and a broken roof near the dark and spooky woods. There were four people in the family. Fact, the dad, multiple, the mom, and factorial and digit, the girls, ages 6 and 3. Multiple was pregnant with a baby who was due to be born in 1 month. It was a beautiful night, and they were having baked goop for dinner. Mom, lied factorial, why are we eating baked goop again? It's hard for me to chew with no front teeth. Mom replied, we're eating goop because we can't afford regular food. The goop wasn't very good food. It was tough and tasted kind of sour. Digit said, I'm interested in learning math since you guys all know it. That's a nice thought. How about we start tonight, said Dad. Dad and Digit walked outside and started working on math. We learned math by drawing math problems in the goop with sticks. You can do it too, Digit. Let's start with some addition and subtraction. An easy one. 523 plus 688. What's the answer, Digit? 3-year-old Digit thought hard while twirling her long brown hair. 1,211? With an impressed look on his face, Dad replied, very good, Digit. After 3 weeks of practice, Digit was multiplying 3-digit by 3-digit numbers. One night, while working on long division, they heard Mom shout, it's time to go to the hospital! The baby is being born! The family quickly jumped from the car and zoomed away to the hospital. They arrived at the hospital at 1 a.m., and Digit and Factorial were fast asleep with their soft cheeks pressed against the window. There were lots of mothers, and half of them, the parents, didn't even understand what they were for. It took about 5 hours before the baby came out. The doctor said, it's a boy! The moment he came out, he started screaming. He was 22 inches long and weighed 9 pounds. The baby looked up with his blue eyes and saw his family. Mom and Dad said, I think we'll name him Sting. 3 years later, Factorial was starting 5th grade, and Digit was starting 7th grade. Factorial was so good at math, the teacher sometimes let her work on her own math out of the hall because she already knew what the class was doing. She was also very instructive by shouting out the answers. Digit's class was working on memorizing math facts, but she already knew all her math facts thoroughly and kept begging the teacher for extra math work. Sting, a skinny blonde kid tall for his age, was learning to count from 1 to 10 and learning colors in preschool. But he really liked music and always came home with one more page of a concerto for violin and piano that he was composing. Sting asked his parents if he could start learning violin because he wanted to play his own compositions. Sting's parents liked to listen to music. They thought too much music would take away his potential for math, and they wanted him to learn more complicated math. All the Adams have always been great at math, said Dad. Why do you just want to play with music all day? Music makes me feel good, and I like improving at something I'm already good at. Music will even help me in math, because you have fractions of beats in music, and you have fractions in math, Sting thoughtfully. Factorial heard what was going on, and stopped working on an algebra problem to come in and give her own opinion. Even though I like math, I still think Sting's right. Math and music do relate. Maybe we could do both. That night, Mom and Dad discussed until midnight whether they should do only math, only music, or both. The next morning, they were still thinking it over, but then they decided to do both because of Factorial statement. Fact and multiple still like math better than music, but they decided that Sting should get to make his own choices. The next week, Sting started taking violin lessons on Tuesday and Thursday. His violin teacher thought that Sting was very talented and should practice 20 minutes a day. Sting enjoyed getting to practice violin every day. Mom and Dad didn't really help him practice. Sting enjoyed practicing on his own, but he would have appreciated if his parents started helping him improve. The next day, Sting was practicing on his own when something very unexpected happens. His parents did not come in to help him, but guess who did? Factorial. Factorial did not know how to play an instrument, but she was extremely good at fractions. Now, when Sting practices the violin, Factorial circles the spot and music with Sting gets the counting wrong. copy one of the younger kids. I think factorial was right. Math and music do relate. The adults figured out that music is an innovative way to do math.